Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear friends, today is Easter Sunday. Today is a day of celebration. This is the day our Lord Jesus broke the chains of death. And he wants us to share in his victory over sin and death. For us to be able to share in his victory, we have to seek and follow God in. So at this Mass, we have to ask the good God to give us all the graces we need in order to remove any obstacle on our way to seeking and following him daily in our lives. Please be our intention for this Mass, and I ask all of you at home to offer your own intentions. So to prepare ourselves for the day to celebrate this Easter Sunday Mass, let us call to mind our sins and ask for God's forgiveness. My dear brothers and sisters, let us humbly beseech the Lord our God to bless this water he has created, which will be sprinkled on us as a memorial of our baptism. May he help us by his grace to remain faithful to the spirit we have received. Lord our God, in your mercy be present to your people's prayers, and for us who recall the wondrous work of our creation and the still greater work of our redemption, graciously bless this water, for you created water to make the fields fruitful and to refresh and cleanse our bodies. You also made water an instrument of your mercy, for through water you freed your people from slavery and quenched their thirst in the desert. Through water the prophets proclaimed the new covenant you were to enter upon with the human race. And last of all, through water which Christ made holy in the Jordan, you have renewed our corrupted nature in the path of regeneration. Therefore, may this water be for us the memorial of the baptism we have received, and grant that we may share in the gladness of our brothers and sisters who at Easter have received their baptism through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We humbly ask you, Almighty God, to be pleased in your faithful love and bless this salt you have created. For it was you who commanded the prophet Elijah to cast salt into water, that the pure water might be purified. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that wherever this mixture of salt and water is sprinkled, every attack of the enemy may be repulsed, and your Holy Spirit may be present to keep us safe at all times, through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
whom on this day, through your only begotten Son, have conquered death and unlocked for us the path to eternity. Grant, we pray, that we who keep the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection may, through the renewal brought by your Spirit, rise up in the light of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. In those days, Peter opened his mouth and said, "You know the word of the word which was proclaimed throughout all the day, beginning from Galilee after the baptism which John preached. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power. How he went about being good and healing all that were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. And we are witnesses to all that he did, both in the country of the Jews and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and made him manifest, not to all the people, but to us who were chosen by God as witnesses, who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. And he commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God to be judge of the living and the dead. To him, all the prophets bear witness that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name."
letter of St. Paul to the Colossians. Brethren, if you have been raised with Christ, seek the things that are above, where Christ is, seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things that are above, not on things that are on earth. For you have died, and your life is hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, appears, then you also will appear with him in glory.
on the first day of the week, Mary of Magdala came to the tomb early in the morning while it was still dark and saw the stone removed from the tomb. So she ran and went to Simon Peter and to the other disciple whom Jesus loved and told them, "They have taken the Lord from the tomb, and we don't know where they put him." So Peter and the other disciple went out and came to the tomb. The boat ran, but the other disciple ran faster than Peter and arrived at the tomb first. He bent down and saw the burial clothes there, but did not go in. When Simon Peter arrived after him, he went into the tomb and saw the burial clothes there, and the clothes that had covered his head, not with the burial clothes, but rolled up in a separate place. Then the other disciple also went in, the one who had arrived at the tomb first, and he saw and believed. For they did not yet understand the scripture that he has to rise from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Boldly giving witness to the mystery of the resurrection of the Lord.
the resurrection of the Lord threw a totally different light on the passion and death of Jesus. It led the disciples to a very different understanding of what at first was a tragedy, disaster, and failure. The experience of the resurrection of the Lord strengthened the faith of the disciples in the risen Jesus and completely transformed their lives because of the resurrection. The disciples who were at first paralyzed in fear of being arrested as accomplices of Jesus suddenly made a complete turnaround and began to boldly proclaim that Jesus, who died on the cross, was alive and with them. There is no doubt that their experience of the Spirit of the risen Lord gave them that unshakable courage that they were ready even to die for this truth that they proclaimed. The celebration of Easter, my dear friends, calls for radical compassion and transformation. The sign that we are truly sharing in this risen life of Jesus is that our lives and our behavior undergo a constant development. We must not only believe, we must also proclaim that we must do what we believe and what we proclaim. We must begin to do things in a different way and see the things that are above. This is the point that St. Paul makes in the second reading today. When we see the things above, we can then joyfully proclaim the message of the resurrection. And what is the message of the resurrection? It is a message of faith in the one who has saved us from sin and death. It is a message of hope that just as Christ rose from the dead, we too will have the last day with him. It is a message of love, that the love he exhibited when he gave his life for us on the cross will show it in our words and deeds. This is the Easter story. This is the Easter joy. Not to share our Easter joy and what it means to us is to live Easter only half celebrated. For the true Christian, in fact, every day is an Easter day. Live joyfully in the close company of the risen Lord. In the Gospel reading, for the Gospel of John, the Evangelist John gives us a moving detail that tells the story of the resurrection. Mary Magdalene came to the tomb while it was still dark and saw that the stone had been taken away. This goes to the very heart of Easter. They came to the tomb and the stone was rolled away. This is strong evidence for the resurrection. Apart from the linen clothes, they found neatly folded inside the empty tomb. The stone was not rolled back for the benefit of Christ, but for the witnesses to the resurrection. Christ did not need the stone to roll back for him to leave the tomb, for material substance has no bearing on spiritual substance. However, the witnesses needed to enter the tomb to see the truth, that it was empty, that he was not dead, that he has risen as he promised. The resurrection means that the good stone that separated the human race from God, the stone that stood like a wall between humanity and God, has been rolled away. And now in Jesus Christ, the way to the Father is once more open. Through the resurrection of Jesus, God's own life flows back into the world. Now eternal life and eternal happiness are possible for all of us. But there is a doubt that darkens Easter. It is not a doubt that Christ rose from the dead. It is doubt on our ability to walk in the newness of life. We doubt that we can become a new creation, that we can be changed and filled with the Holy Spirit. We feel that this goal in our life is too massive, too big. That Jesus rose to new life is easy to believe. We doubt that we can rise to new life in Him. And then we are quick to ask, can the God of Genesis, who separated darkness from light, who brought the entire magnificent world into being from nothing, make me a new creation and give me new life? The resurrection says yes. If God created the universe, He can surely recreate you. Again, we sometimes ask, can the God of Exodus, who delivered the Israelites from slavery and bondage, deliver me from the bondage of sin? The resurrection of Jesus Christ says yes. If God could free the Israelites, He can certainly free you and me. Today, more than ever, we are asking, can the God who defeated sin and death by His glorious passion and resurrection deliver us from the COVID-19 pandemic? The resurrection of Jesus says yes. If God will defeat the devil, He will certainly deliver us from the present predicament. If we embrace holy living, then we know the personal prayer life, join the church for daily mass, we will notice the Easter light gradually entering our lives. We will notice the stone in our life being rolled away. We may not find that all our problems will be suddenly vanished, but we will find new strength and courage to walk through them. Easter is a time to discover a personal relationship with the risen Christ within the life of the church. It is a relationship that no one can ever take away from us. It will make us better and greater than we are and will never end. We will come to see that all the promises of Christ and all the parables of Christ are for us and about us. And then what happened to the faithful disciples who experienced the recreation and came to know new life powered by the Holy Spirit can happen to us. Because of the resurrection of Jesus, Easter is the Sunday, the season when the stone in our lives will roll away. This is the Sunday and the season of the second chance for all of us. As we celebrate Easter today, let us rejoice and be glad because we are serving a living God and not a dead God. Let our actions be actions that bring joy and happiness to others. By rising from the dead, He has restored us to life. This is the reason for our joy. Let us carry the message of the resurrection to the poor, the sick, and the brokenhearted, that beyond the gloomy darkness of the grave lies the glorious dawn of Easter morning. That beyond the COVID-19 pandemic lies a new world, where we all acknowledge the power of God and give glory to the risen God. I pray that the risen Christ will accompany you in all that you do, and that the joy we feel this day will remain with you and your families and follow you everywhere you go through Christ our Lord. May God bless you and your families this Easter season. Once again, happy Easter to you all. And so now that our Lenten observance is concluded, let us renew the promises of holy baptism by which we once renounced Satan and his works and promised to serve God in the Holy Catholic Church. And so I ask you, do you renounce Satan and all his works and all his empty promises seated at the right hand of the Father. Do you believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting? And may Almighty God, the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has given us new birth by water and the Holy Spirit, and bestowed on us forgiveness of our sins, keep us by his grace in Christ Jesus our Lord for eternal life. Amen. This is the day the Lord has made. When Jesus Christ rose from the dead, let us come to God our Father in prayer to ask him through our risen Lord to give us all the graces necessary to be witnesses to the power of the resurrection.
Holy Church, the body of Christ, when she preached Christ's resurrection as her own triumph over sin, death, and the world, and thus to proclaim the victory by King Jesus' blood, the glory of the Father. Hear us, O Lord, let your light shine upon us. We pray, O Lord. May they bring the hope of resurrection to all the people of this land and seek peace and harmony in industry and in all areas of public life. Hear us, O Lord, let your light shine upon us.
May all Christians, through the power of the resurrection, give them renewed hope for the future. Hear us, O Lord. Let your light shine upon us. We pray, O Lord. To share in his glory. Hear us, O Lord. Let your light shine upon us. We pray, O Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. Pope Francis' prayer for protection from coronavirus. O Mary, you shine continuously on our journey as a sign of salvation and hope. We entrust ourselves to you, helpers of the sick. At the foot of the cross, we participated in Jesus' pain with steadfast faith. You, salvation of the Roman people, know what we need. We accept that you will provide, so that as you did at Cana of Galilee, joy and feasting might return after this moment of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform ourselves to the Father's will and to do what Jesus tells us. He who took our sorrows upon himself and bore our sorrows to bring us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. We seek refuge under your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our pleas. We who are put to the test, and deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. prayer for Nigeria in distress. All-powerful and merciful Father, you are a God of justice, love, and peace. You rule over all the nations of the earth. Power and might are in your hands, and no one can sustain you. We present our country, Nigeria, before you. We praise and thank you, for you are the source of all we are and are. We are sorry for all the sins we have committed, and for the good deeds we have failed to do. In your loving forgiveness, keep us safe from the punishment we deserve. Lord, we are well done, not only by our sanctities, but also by our moral, economic, and political progress. Listen to the cries of your people, who confidently turn to you. God of infinite goodness, our strength in adversity, our hurt in weakness, our comfort in sorrow. Be merciful to us, your people. Spare this nation, Nigeria, from chaos, anarchy, and doom. Bless us with your kingdom of justice, love, and peace. We ask this through Christ our Lord. We make our prayers with Mary in our Easter joy as we say, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, and our deity. We pray in silence for our own intentions, in our true power of the risen Lord.
Hear the prayers we offer in all our hearts, so that the message of Easter may be with us always. Through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at his hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Exultant with pastoral gladness, O Lord, we offer the sacrifice by which your church is wondrously reborn and nourished through Christ our Lord. Dominus Bonis Cum,
et Spiritus
Sanctus, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church, begins to grant her peace, to guide life and womanhood throughout the whole world. Together with your servant Francis and boldly your holy servant, and all those who hold it to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Remember, Lord, your servants and all gathered here, whose faith and devotion are known to you. For them we offer you this sacrifice of praise. For they will offer it for themselves and all who are here today, for the redemption of their souls, the hope of health and well-being, and pay their homage to you, eternal God, living and true. Celebrating the most sacred day of the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ in the flesh, and in communion with those whose memory we venerate, especially the glorious Ever Virgin Mary, Mother of God and Lord Jesus Christ. And blessed yourself and spouse, your blessed apostles and martyrs, Peter and Paul, Andrew, James, John, Thomas, James, Philip, Bartholomew, Matthew, Simon, and Jude, Linus, Clemens, Clement, Sisters, Cornelius, Cyprian, Lawrence, Chrysogonus, John and Paul, Cosmas and David, and all your saints, we ask that through their merits and prayers, in all things, may be defended by our protecting them. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Therefore, Lord, we pray graciously accept this oblation of our service, that of your whole family, order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock that you have chosen. We please, O God, we pray to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect, make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread with his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ, your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts that you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread and eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you will have pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel, the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, the holy sacrifice, the spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that this gift be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing through Christ our Lord.
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in a sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace through Christ our Lord. To us also, your servants, who those sinners, hope your abundant mercies, graciously grant some share and fellowship with the apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, Ignatius, Alexander, Marcellinus, Peter, Felicity, Perpetua, Agatha, Lucy, Agnes, Cecilia, Anastasia, and all your saints. Admit us to receive you into their company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to make all these things, good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, to deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Lamb of God, Lamb of God, take the justice of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, take the justice of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Out of three. sacrificial communion. By Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Eternity's on earth.